Yeah.
You're rocking with Sir Quentin Best.
Best of the best entertainment presets. Your feature presentation. But I'm Milwaukee.
Yo, what's going down? It's your boy Sir Quentin, professor of the best entertainment, where we keep our eyes and our ears open for local, global, up and coming and established artists. Today, we rocking out with a familiar face, man. Thank you for coming back to the show, man.
My man, you already know it. Always, always a pleasure, man. Always.
So what you got going on, man? It's a lot that went on since
last time we spoke. I was here. I think the second Mansa Musa, I was putting that out last time I was here. So since then, I put out the third one. And it's went gangbusters, I'll put it that way. The response has been overwhelming. We still pushing it. It's been out for like 4 months. I put it out November 1st on all digital platforms. And the streams and reviews was crazy. You know what I mean? It did well on Spotify, Apple Music, you know what I mean? YouTube, everywhere so far. So I'm still kind of like overwhelmed by that. You know what I'm saying? But I'm also proud of it because we took our time with it and I put a lot of effort into it. And everybody I called out for their services and their favors showed up and gave me A1
because I see it's a lot of big names, a lot of helping hands with this project, exactly. Man. You want to shout them out real quick?
Yeah, for sure. Like, I got Munch Lauren on the project, Ray Rizzi's on the project. I don't want to forget no names, but Jazzy's on the project, Trax is on the project, Fees is on the project, my boy Dooch. I know I'm forgetting some people. We got Dre on the album. Like I said, everybody just showed up and, you know, knocked it out the park with me. Even on a production tip, like 40 Mil did a track for me. My man Don, the jeweler, did a track for me. So, like, even and my man Sounds, shout out Sounds. Sounds gave me a track, too. So, it's like everybody that I called in, my favors from, you know, work that I done put in all these years doing this,
right.
They all showed up and gave me.
The visual side, too. You had a lot of a visual aspect, too. You want to shout them out, too?
Yeah, for sure. Crown shot the video for Black Excellence. That's the lead track off the album featuring my deceased father. You know what I'm saying? Also, want to shout out Bricks for the album cover because the album cover is a playoff of one of my dad's old album covers. You know what I'm saying?
So, all right, it's fine.
Yeah, Bricks killed that. So I want to shout out Bricks, too, for the artwork. So like I said, it's just a collection of Milwaukee, you know, finest that I was able to all pull together to give you these 16 tracks that go all different places. We go to the club, you know me, I'm all over the place. So we go to the club, we got records that make you think. It's a record on there that people said they're going to be playing at their weddings. You know what I'm saying? So it's some of everything on there. I was able to get my pops on there. You know what I mean? So it's a little bit of everything on this project. So it's Mansa Musa 3. That is all Carry On. It's available anywhere you can download or anywhere music is digital.
And you're doing a lot of cross promoting, too, with your podcast. Let's touch on that, man.
Exactly. Also, yeah, Smoking Gossip, man, with Spoiled Rotten and sometimes Bree. She with us once a week. We trying to get her back to 3 days. But Smoking Gossip, man, is every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And we just we touch on everything that going on in the culture. But we try to make it really home-based. So, you know, we talk about all topics, but we keep it very Milwaukee, and we keep it very, you know, up top and all about, you know, bigging up what's going on around here, making sure we got a voice and a presence. You know what I'm saying? So that's what else is going on with that. I just did 88.9 radio station.
I just saw that, too.
Got a live performance on YouTube, too. You can go check that out. It's like 20 minutes, and they saluted me, and they also helped me get my dad's day. So it's Harvey Scales Day in the city of Milwaukee now every February 13th, you know what I mean, of every year. So shout out 88.9 for that too, man.
So what does that entail, the day? They explain that. So
the way the day works is it's like any other day. You know how we got President's Day and all these other holidays. So I just thought it was only fitting that my dad, the first artist to ever go platinum in music, you know what I'm saying, should have his own day in the city of Milwaukee.
Yeah, we should get off of work for that,
yeah,
too, man.
Exactly.
That's the first man to go platinum was Black,
all
man.
All artists should be off work. Yeah, if you do any kind of music, you should have that
you
day.
You
got to
show that BMI or ASCAP.
Yeah,
I got
exactly.
This, boss. I'm off work right here.
Free studio time or something, you know what I mean? Something should go on. You should be able to cash in a chip that day. But, no, it was just really to make sure that he was recognized for his works and that people know that, you know, he grew up in Lapham Park and he had an eighth grade education and he wrote one of the biggest songs in American music history. You know
which
what
was
saying?
What?
Disco Lady for Johnny Taylor. You know what I'm saying? So, first song to ever go platinum. in music history. So I just wanted to make sure he was respected and recognized for that. And it was also something that we talked about before he died. Because a running joke was his was, man, the Fonzie got a statue. He ain't even a real person. You know what I'm saying? Like, how I ain't got my own day or a key to the city or a statue or something. So it was. I just was happy that 88.9 was able to help me make that happen. You know what I mean? Shout out to
the
mayor.
What was the process?
I don't really know. I think they had a more pull than I probably would have had. You know what I mean? It came up in a conversation about me doing my performance at the radio station, and they was like, man, let's do it Black History Month. And then we'll take the whole day and dedicate it to your father. And then I'll also talk to the mayor about getting a proclamation and making it Harvey Scales Day. And I'm like, oh, yeah, man, okay, thanks. You know what I'm saying? You know, because my family, we had talked about it, but, you know, we didn't know really how to go about doing it. But, you know, radio, they got connections with the city and they know how to handle. So they got it done. Next time me and Don talked to them, they was like, yeah, oh, yeah, by the way, we got the proclamation from the mayor and your dad's day is going to be February 13th. You know what I mean?
This, yeah, I know we going to shout out your dad, you know, but this day and all that, it all like came out the roots from your grind. You know,
yeah,
what I'm saying?
Absolutely,
like,
absolutely. You right about that. That's on point with that. I appreciate that too, Quinn, because it's how the universe working. It all tied into the album. You get what I'm saying? The timing of his death. I lost him around this same time last year, and then I released the album in November. Like I said, you know what I'm saying? With my image and my covers is of him, you know what I mean? And that wasn't the plan. You see what I'm saying? When I originally set out to do the project, I had a whole nother direction I was going to go in. But when he passed, it changed my focus. You know what I'm saying? And you're right. It's because of the groundwork and the connections and things that I established to be able to have those things coincide with making sure that he got his day. You know what I mean?
Not to cut you off,
man. Go ahead.
But I always want to know, like, were you all like a family of music? Did he instill music into you, or was
actually,
it just like something that just...
Actually, it wasn't. It wasn't like that. And it's funny that you asked that question. I was just around. You know how almost like my daughter. My daughter wants to DJ now. You know what I'm saying? But when my daughter was little, I used to have her at the studio. Shout out Fourth Coast. But I used to have her at the studio with Money Eyes, Spoil Rod and Ray, Rizzy, Lyle Pack, Larry, them her uncles. And she used to be at the studio with them when she was like 2-3 years old. So now she's gotten older. She has an interest in DJing. I never pushed her into writing a rap or wanting to do music. You know what I mean? She know who her grandfather is, but I got nephews and nieces who rap too. But I never pushed it on them. We kind of lead by example, because that's kind of how my daddy did it. He
and
just
they
brought
say,
you
they
around.
They say kids, yeah, they learn from what you do, not what you tell them.
I was never pushed into it. You know what I mean? My mother, like, I think my mother was an educator, so she used to make me write, and I used to have to learn, like, Martin Luther King speeches and Frederick Douglass speeches, so that helped with my memory. And then the music was just in me because of my dad. So I think that's what led me to being a writer, which led me to being more of a rapper as opposed to a singer. You see what I'm saying? Because my dad was also a writer, too. You know what I mean? But I think the education factor that came from my mom made me the type of writer that I am. You know what I'm saying? So, no, it was never pushed on me. But music was always in the household, of course, because of who he was. But it was never like, go before you go to bed, you know, like Joe Jackson type shit. Like, you know what I mean? It was never like, before you go to bed, whoop you, get your guitars and your brothers and get. No, he was never on that. It was just more like, I got the studio today, and you with me. I'm baby, you know what I mean? I got my son with me, and we at the studio today. You know what I mean? And he was cutting records for everybody as a kid. Now that I'm older, I'm realizing, like, oh, damn, he was cutting this record for Gerald LaVert and him. I didn't know that as a kid. I'm at the studio playing with my He-Man and G.I. Joes, you know what I'm saying? But as I get older, like, damn, that studio session, they was working on a record for LaVert, you know what I mean? Or, you know what I mean? So it was more or less like,
in your brain.
Exactly, like, leading by example. And a kid, like, kids will adapt to whatever, you know, and I just adapted to it. Being used to being in the studio, having studio etiquette, because I used to have to be a kid and have to be quiet and, you know what I mean? A lot of cats didn't have that when I was in high school and we was going to the studio. Niggas didn't even know how to
bring a million niggas to the studio.
Exactly. I got studio etiquette from being around my dad. You know what I mean? Absolutely. So just little things that you pick up like that. Yep.
So y'all see, man, he ain't stopped yet. I don't foresee him stopping at all, man. And, you know, Mansa Musa 3 is out. All platforms, correct?
Yes, sir.
Just look up Harvey Scales Jr., right?
Yes, sir.
Got to look that up. You got to put the junior, too. But don't hesitate to put the senior, you know what I'm saying? But you know we had to pick the brain of Harvey Scales, man.
You know how we do it, man.
He got to bring me on Smoking Gossip ASAP, man. But yeah, man, we had to pick the brain of Harvey Scales, man. Y'all get in tune. Y'all get locked in. Any last minute shout outs, man?
No, I just want to say shout out to y'all for this platform, man. I've been watching it and it's grown since the last time I was on here. That's why I'm honored to be back and do it again. But also, I want to shout out a brother by the name of Bobby Deuce. You know what I'm saying? And we about to start doing some big things. He about to make me go into the second part of my career, which is about to get into like acting and scripts. You know what I mean? He a brother from here that's doing independent films right here out of Milwaukee. You know what I'm saying? So I'm about to start doing some stuff with him. He about to shoot a music video for me. And then from there, we're going to start looking at some scripts and working on some movies. So I wanted to shout him out. Also, I want to shout out my man, Don. You know what I'm saying? Like the black hand of this. You know what I mean? He's been helping me through this whole process and making it really, you know, seem for real. Like we really, you know, and it is for real. Like we really making moves and stuff is really happening without really having to like, you know, pull a lot of strings. People are really respecting the work ethic. So I just want to shout out Don for that. Also, I want to shout out Smoking Gossip. Make sure you tune in every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 7:30. You know what I'm saying? To talk about the latest things going on in the culture and the latest things happening in our city. And also, like he just said, man, make sure you go get that Mansa Musa 3. It's available everywhere. Google Play Store, Amazon Music, Tidal, Spotify, iTunes. Man, we out here. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you holler at me, man. Follow me on Instagram, JR Scales, HBK. Follow me on Facebook, Harvey Scales Jr. and JR Scales. I got two pages now because they put me in jail for
a minute. Yeah, I seen that.
Yeah, man. But I'm back fresh out of jail, California dream.
Can't hold nobody down, man. You know what I'm saying?
Feeling like Pac out here. You know what I mean? But I'm back. But yeah, man, like I said, man, shout out best of the best. And y'all make sure y'all tune in, man.
Y'all lock it in, man. Y'all support, man. Support your city. And Bobby Deuce. What up, man?
Yes.
I got you back on your camera, too, man. Don't hate me, dog. But, yeah, man, it's your boy, Sir Quinn. We rocking out with Harvey Scales Jr. And like I always say, shut up and hustle.
Yeah. I feel like Sansa. Pocket full of blues, I'ma throw them at a dancer. Right here, I ain't got no manners. Baby girl, shake it like it's codeine in my
fanta. That's the best entertainment.
Little mama go nuts. Planters.
Shut up and hustle.
Money problems, we got all that.